Welcome to all of you. Today in this session we are going to discuss about the structure of agents. So agent functions and programs. An agent is completely specified by the agent function mapping percept sequences to actions. The job of the artificial intelligence is to design an agent program that implements the agent function. We assume this program will run on some sort of computing device with physical sensors and actuators, which is known as the architecture. So what is agent? Agent is nothing but the agent program plus architecture. So obviously the program we choose should have the appropriate for the architecture. If the program is going to recommend the action like walk, the architecture must have the legs for walking. The architecture might be just an ordinary PC or it might be a robotic car with several onboard computers, cameras and other sensors. The architecture makes the percepts from the sensors available to the programs, runs the program and feeds the program's action choices to the actuators. Agent programs. The agent program takes the current percept as input from the sensors and returns an action to the actuators. There is a difference between the agent function and the agent program. So what is this difference? Agent program takes only the current percept as input, but the agent function takes the entire percept history as input. That means the agent program depends upon only the current percept, while the agent function depends upon the previous percepts also. The agent program takes just a current percept as input because nothing more is available from the environment. If the agent's action needs to depend on the entire percept sequence, then the agent will have to remember the percepts. That is, if the agent needs to remember the whole percept sequence, if it needs it. So, figure shows here the trivial agent program. This program keeps the track of the percept sequence and uses this track to index into the table of actions to decide what to do. The table here represents the agent function that the agent program includes. So this is the agent function that includes the agent program. To build the rational agent, the designer must construct a table that contains the appropriate action for every possible percept sequence. If P be the set of possible percepts and T be the lifetime of the agent, so what is this lifetime means? It is the total number of percepts it will receive. Then the lookup table will contain P raised to T entries, which is a very huge number. So the table becomes very huge due to this much of entries. There are certain drawbacks of this table driven approach. So what are these drawbacks? No physical agent in this universe will have the space to store such a huge table. So no space to store the table here. The designer would not have time to create the table. So it will take a very long time to build the table. So this is another drawback. So no agent could ever learn how to write table entries from its experience. So here there is no any autonomy. So that is one more drawback. So even if the environment is simple enough, to yield a feasible table size, the designer will has no guidance about how to fill the table entries. So this is one more drawback of table lookup agent. It is even with learning need a long time to learn the table entries. Agent types. The key challenge for the artificial intelligence is to write programs that produce rational behavior from small programs rather than from vast tables. So rather than a table, how we can produce rational behavior is from a small amount of code. The four basic types in order to increasing generality for the agent types are listed below. The simple reflex agent, model based reflex agent, goal based agents and utility based agents. So in today's session we are going to see what is the simple reflex agent. A simple reflex agent is a simple kind of agent. These agents select actions on the basis of the current percept and ignores the rest of the percept history. Okay, so its action depends only on the current percept and it ignores the previous history of the persons. So here we consider the example of vacuum cleaner agent. Because its decision is based on the current location and on whether that location contains dirt. An agent program for vacuum cleaner agent is shown here in the figure. This vacuum agent program is very small as compared to corresponding table lookup agent. The most obvious reduction is from ignoring the percept history, which reduces the number of possibilities. Here the number of possibilities are 4 raised to these are just 4 rather than 4 raised to t in case of table lookup agent. Okay, so this reduction this reduces the number of possibilities from 4 raised to t to just 4. The further reduction comes from the fact when the current square is dirty, the action does not depend on the location. It just cleans the square. We will consider one more example of driver of the automated taxi. If the car in front brakes and its brake lights come on, then the driver should notice this and initiate braking. Some processing is done on the visual input to establish the condition. So what is this condition? The car in front is braking. Then this triggers some established connection in the agent program to the action initiate braking. We call such a connection a condition action rule, written as if a car in front is braking, then initiate braking. So this is nothing but the condition action rule performed by the driver. Humans also have many such connections, some of which are learned from responses and some of which are initiate or innate reflexes. A more general and flexible approach is first to build a general purpose interpreter for condition action rules and then to create the rule sets for specific task environments. The figure gives the structure of this general program in schematic form. This shows how the condition action rules allow the agent to make the connection from percept to action. We use rectangles to denote the current initiate state of the agent's decision process and ovals to represent the background information. So here it includes two rectangles which denotes the current internal state of the agent's decision process, and it contains one oval which represents the background information. Okay, here the sensors perceives from the environment gives this percept to the agent. So what the world is like now, according to that the action is generated. Okay, so what action I should do now is decided depending upon the condition action rules, and the action is taken by the actuators and provided to the environment. Okay, so this is the schematic diagram for a simple reflex agent. So as we have described earlier, okay, first here we build a general purpose interpreter for condition action rule, and then we create a rule sets for specific task environments. So as we have defined earlier, rectangles are defined to denote the current internal state of the agent's decision process, and ovals are used to represent the background information used in the process. The interpret input function generates an abstract description of the current state from the percept, and a rule match function returns the first rule in the set of rules that matches the given set description. The decisions in terms of rules and matching is purely conceptual, and actual implementations are also simple. Simple reflex agents are simple, but they turn out to be of very limited intelligence. The agent will work only if the correct decision can be made on the basis of the current percept, that is, only if the environment is fully observable. Even a little bit of unobservability can cause serious trouble here. We will take one example here. The braking rule given earlier assumes that the condition car in front is braking can be determined from the current percept, that is, from a single frame of video. This works if the car in front has a centrally mounted brake light. So, but as the different cars have different configurations of it, it is not always possible to tell from a single image whether the car is braking or not. The simple reflex agent driving behind such a car would either brake continuously and unnecessarily, or in worst case, never brake at all. A similar problem may arise in the vacuum cleaner agent. Suppose a simple reflex vacuum agent has a damaged location sensor and has only a dirt sensor. Such an agent has only two possible percepts, dirty and clean. It can suck in response to dirty, but what it do in response to clean? Okay, if the response is dirty, then it will suck, but what to do when the response is clean? So moving left fails forever if it happens to start in square A, and moving right fails forever if it happens to start in square B. Infinite loops are often unavoidable for simple reflex agents operating in partially observable environments. Escape from initial loops is possible if the agent can randomize its actions. So here, infinite loops are often unavoidable when escape action is provided. So, for example, if the vacuum agent in previous case perceives clean, it might flip a coin to choose between left and right. In this way, the agent will reach to other square in an average of 2 steps. Then if that square is dirty, the agent will clean it and task will be complete. A randomized simple reflex agent might outperform a deterministic simple reflex agent. Randomized behavior of the right kind can be rational in some multi-stage environments. In single-stage environment, randomization is usually not rational. It is a useful trick that helps a simple reflex agent in some situations, but in most cases, we will do much better with more sophisticated deterministic agents. So this is all about the structure of the agent, and we have seen here the simple reflex agent. Thank you.